Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise? Be seated. Welcome. Dear friends and family, we're gathered here today to witness and celebrate the union of Seth and Kayele in marriage. In the years that they've been together, their love and understanding for each other has grown and matured, and now they've decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. Who gives this lady to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. Okay.
Again.
Let us have a word of prayer. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for the opportunities that you present to us each and every day, and to come together on a beautiful day like today to share this event with this young man and young lady as they begin this union and they're sharing their lives together. And we just ask that at this time that you would wrap your arms around them and just protect them and guide them as they begin this new chapter in their life. Lord, we just ask you would be with each and everybody that's here, those that are traveling, keep everybody safe and sound. We ask all these things in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
You know, the Bible reminds us of the importance and value that it is in a relationship that's shared between a man and woman. None other of God's creations has the opportunity to bring fulfillment and glory to God but in that of the union of a man and woman. The scripture says that a man named the cattle, the birds in the air, and the wild animals, but he didn't find a suitable companion. God put the man into a deep sleep. As he slept, he removed one of the ribs and replaced it with flesh. God then used the rib that he had taken from the man to make a woman and presented her to the man. The man said, "Finally, bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, name her woman, for she has made from man." In creation, Adam was formed first. It was so that woman may be for men as church is for Christ. God was intentional about the creation of woman. Even the fact that Eve was created out of the rib from Adam was significant. Not from the feet to be dominated by him, but from his side for protection and from near his heart to know his love. 1 Corinthians 13:4 through 8 tells us, "Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It's not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its way. It is not irritable or resentful, does not rejoice in the wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. As for the prophecies, they will pass away. As for the tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. Seth, Kayele, please join hands. You've done that. And face each other. Seth, do you take Kayele to be your wife, to live together under God's will in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poor, for better, for worse, in sadness and in joy, to cherish and continually bestow upon her your heart's deepest devotion, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kayele, do you take Seth to be your husband, to live together under God's will in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sadness and in joy, to cherish and continually bestow upon him your heart's deepest devotion, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
How about a little marriage advice? Comedian Jeff Allen said that a happy wife is a happy life. Well, while true, more appropriately, maybe it's a happy spouse is a happy house. Someone asked me last night if I had counseled y'all. And I'll let you know back there, I have. It wasn't recently. It was several years ago. In fact, I think it was Seth's first year of teaching. And it was during spring break, the Houston Livestock Show. And Seth was there as any good young ag teacher. He was challenging his kids, but more importantly, he was trying to get Barra's ready to show. And he was pretty dialed in with, as with anybody with good focus, Seth was really dialed in. In fact, Kayele had driven all the way to Houston from up here on the plains, the South Plains, and gonna surprise Seth. And when she drove in and got to Houston and might have had some food in her hand, and he was following a Chester Barra down the aisle, and Kayele happened upon him, and she said, "Hey, Seth." And Seth just kind of smiled and said, "Hey," and he just kept following that pig. A short time later, Kayele comes over to our row and camp where we were at, and there might have been a few tears shed during that time, and took Kayele by putting my arm around her, and we got through that, and we talked a little bit about the appropriate time and place and planning and maybe give him a heads up. And then later on, we were sitting there watching. I don't know if it was that Chester Barra, whatever was happening, but I caught Seth in the stands. And we visited a little bit about acting surprised and embracing her with a hug occasionally. And so... But more importantly, just kind of figure it out and go with it. But we learned that we had to share our time with each other. And these were going to be events that are going to happen for the rest of our days. And Seth doing what he loves to do and Kayele supporting him. And so, yes, to answer you, we've counseled a little bit. All right. May we have the rings, please? All right, Seth, repeat after me. I, Seth, take you, Kayele.
I, Seth, take you, Kayele.
To be my lawfully wedded wife, my constant friend.
To be my lawfully wedded wife and my constant friend.
My faithful partner.
Oh, go ahead.
And my love from this day forward.
My faithful partner and my love from this day forward.
In the presence of God, our family and friends.
In the presence of God, our family and friends.
I offer you solemn vow to be your faithful partner.
I offer you solemn vow to be our faithful partner.
Through sickness and in health, in good times and bad.
Through sickness and health, in good times and bad.
In joy as well as sorrow.
and joy as well as sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally and support you in your goals.
Promise to love you unconditionally and support you in your goals.
To honor and respect you and laugh with you and cry with you.
To honor and respect you, laugh with you, and cry with you.
And to cherish you as long as we both shall live.
And to cherish you as long as we both shall live.
All right, Kayele. Repeat after me. I, Kayele, take you, Seth.
I, Kayele, take you, Seth.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
My faithful partner and my love from this day forward.
My faithful partner and my love from this day forward.
In the presence of God, our family, and friends.
In the presence of God, our family, and friends.
I offer you solemn vow to be your faithful partner in sickness and in health.
I offer my solemn vow to be your partner in sickness and in health.
In good times and bad, and in joy as well as in sorrow.
In good times and bad, as well as joy and sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally, to support you in your goals, and to honor and respect you.
I promise to love you unconditionally, to support your goals, and to honor you and respect you.
To laugh with you and cry with you, and to cherish you as long as we both shall live.
To laugh with you and cry with you, and to cherish you as we both shall live.
Put this on his finger. Seth, you may kiss your bride. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Seth Durham.
The good love when we're all alone. Keep it up, girl. Yeah, you turn me on. I'm hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me. I'm hooked on a feeling.
Right now, let's hear it for Cooper and Kayele. All right, right behind Cooper and Kayele, we got Jacob Shady. Hey, that makes noise. Then we got Guy and Shaylee. Put your hands in the air. You just don't care what you do. Then behind them, Jordan and Tammy. Raise them up if you got them for Langdon and Denver. Keep it going for Clay and Bailey. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, you got to make some noise. You got to get up, stand up. You got to rise up. You got to raise those glasses up. Ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. and Mrs. Seth Durham.
First of all, I want to acknowledge the most important people here today, the bar staff, and Kaylee's personal photographer, Jamie. Make sure to get good angles of the girlfriend, because we all know this picture is going to be around her house for the next 30 years, saying, it's been 6 days since I've married the man of my dreams, 15 days since I'm married, and then 1 month since my sister gave the most amusing matron of honor speech people have ever heard. Cheers and welcome to the amazing wedding we've all been waiting for, and thank you for traveling here today for this special couple. Seth and Kayele, I'm beyond honored to be a part of this special day. For everyone that doesn't know me, what a shame. Y'all are seriously missing out. I'm Kayele's sassy, smart, you know what, loving sister, Bailey. Man, I never thought this day would come. Seth, when people say wait for marriage, you took that quite literally. I mean, come on now. 4 years, 8 months, and 4 days before you finally proposed? Yeah, I got that down to the dot, okay? And then making us all wait a year and a half for the actual big day. As some people would say in our family, it's about dang time. Still tells a valuable lesson in life, and that lesson is to be very patient. Just kidding. Anyways, we are very proud to officially welcome you into this crazy family. But this isn't just the end of the speech just yet, so bear with me, okay? Kayele and I go way back. We met in the 2000s. Kayele was 10 when I first entered her life. When Kayele was stripped away from being the spotlight, it really exercised her creativity throughout the years. Whether it was pulling a softball bat on me to keep her safe from my horn, or leaving me to walk 7 miles home from the Stanford pig barn because she was mad at me, resulting me into telling our parents all about our sneaking out, our hair sneaking out of the house episodes to go party. I was a good one, okay? What a trip that was, I must say. Come to find out, over the years, Kayele and I had a lot in common. For example, we love to be hellions on our dear, loving parents. From sneaking out to go hang out with friends, to throwing secret parties at our house, and blaming it all on our poor neighbor, mudding in my old 2000 Avalanche, don't worry. The entire time I had that vehicle, we only were blessed to get stuck twice, okay? To throwing handmade bombs with our varsity basketball team across town in my mom's Tahoe that we stole, resulting in almost getting arrested before a big basketball game, my idea also, to say the least. No one was harmed in the process, just so everyone's aware, we're all good. Or just hanging out and having the best time with one another, doing absolutely nothing. Kayele had become my best friend and my go-to girl, to say the least. Now Seth, on the other hand. When I first met Seth, it was at the San Antonio Stock Show my senior year of high school. I had gotten sent to the Dead Sea with my show animal and had just gotten off crutches from a knee injury in basketball. So I was out there hobbling around.
Hold it closer to your mouth.
Hobbling around, minding my own business, waiting for the judge to come in the ring. You know, just chilling. I start hearing this guy scream, and when I see scream, it was a scream. Show! I look in the stands and I see Seth making direct eye contact with me. And needless to say, at this time, I didn't know him. Sorry. I just remember thinking in my mind, who the heck do you think you're yelling at, buddy? I was also grateful, though, because the judge pulled me out of the Dead Sea and I won my class. So you're forgiven for now. But that will be the last time you ever yell at me again. Fast forward to now, I've grown to really love Seth, even though he knows which buttons to push to aggravate me. Seth, I will say, out of the long 6 years I've known you, you've also turned into one of my most favorite people to be around. I know I could call you and you'd be there for me in a heartbeat, if I needed you to be. Kayele nailed the jackpot when she met you, and so did you when you met Kayele. I mean that with my whole heart. You both amaze me, and the love Kayele has for you is unmeasured. Kayele goes above and beyond in everything she does. When she dreams big, and when she loves hard. She is soft-hearted, funny, driven to be the best she could possibly be, amazing, and is my inspiration. She is my best friend, my shoulder to cry on, my listening ear, and the best sister I could have ever asked for. She's been my greatest supporter, and she has also told me when I was in the wrong. She's seen me at my worst and also at my best and still loved me through it all. She's my most honest and trustworthy friend, someone who will take all my secrets to the grave, and on top of that, she is the most kind, loving, and generous soul I've ever met. With that being said, Seth, you have received a one-of-a-kind woman. She will cherish and love you forever, I promise that. Seth goes above and beyond for the things he wants. He is genuine, kind, funny, strong-willed, determined, and loves hard as well. He has exceeded every expectation of what a man is supposed to be and is the most amazing man to my sister. I could never repay you for the love you have given her. I'm grateful to have you a part of this family, and I'm excited to see y'all move mountains in the years to come. I apologize for this speech being so long. There are so many great memories and great things to say about this special couple. With that being said, I'm going to end on this note. Seth and Kayele, I pray when times get tough, you will lean on each other. Be there for one another. Be each other's safe place. Laugh together. Pray together. Stay true to one another. Be each other's shoulder to cry on. And continue to share the love for one another like you do today, forever and plus some. I love you both with my whole heart, and I'm excited to see what blessings God grants you in life. Everybody, please raise your glasses and cheers to the now Mr. and Miss Durham.
That was awesome. I thought she was terrific.
Yeah. Well, for as long as I can remember, Seth's been my best friend. And now, Kayele, you've got him. But we still got to go golfing on Sundays. So, Kayele, you know, we're like brother and sister. From what I can remember, Seth was doing a midterm one time. And me and you decided that we were going to bicker and fight it with each other. And we got sent to our rooms, like two little kids, so Seth could finish his midterm. You know? And from what I can think, that was the funniest thing that happened between us. I can think of a lot of other stories, but we'll keep them for later. And Seth, I mean, we probably need to leave that between me and you, but Minneapolis was a fun trip. So, all I can say is I love both of y'all, or both of my best friends, and here's to y'all, Seth and Kayele.
Yeah. Gets a little hot over there. Miss Denver. There, girl.
The green?
You're on. Just hold it up.
You don't make me cry.
I'm gonna do my best. So, I was gonna start off with Seth, but you know what they say. You always gotta save the best for last. So, dear Kayele, we've came a long way. From you and your friends running away from me, and mostly you, giving me such bad wedgies I couldn't pick them out myself. But I'll never forget the memories of when I was in the second grade and you threatened me with your life that you were gonna turn your red Monte Carlo around if I didn't tell you my crush that instant. Now, I tell you pretty much everything, but changing the subject a little, I'm happy you found a man who can actually put up with you. I must say, kind of surprised. So, dear Seth, thank you for sneaking out with me to get ice cream or food whenever we don't want to be at the house. Thanks for jamming out in the car with me and for paying for all my food when I come see y'all. But I also want to say thank you. Thank you for loving, for caring, and for taking care of my older sister. Seeing her here tonight and every other night, seeing the way she looks at you, makes me so proud to be able to say she's truly loved and cared for by an amazing man. I really don't know how he puts up with you. All my life, I've wanted an older brother. A brother to create so many memories along the way. A brother that loves me as much as I love him, and I'm proud to say I gained that wish tonight. Kaylee, thank you for being my rock, my built-in best friend, and my mother when I needed you to be. But most importantly, thank you for being my sister when times got rough and taking my side through it all. Thank you for being my shoulder to cry on, and I wouldn't be where I am without you. So thank you all for letting me be a part of y'all's special day, and I love y'all.
My girl, Denver.
Great job, Denver. Ladies and gentlemen, raise your glasses up nice and high for Bailey, Clay, and Denver, and raise them up real high for Mr. and Mrs. Durham. Let me tell you something. Hey, that's not easy to do, to get up there and be that emotional and read something for people that are so important to you.
Your attention, please. The cake cutting ceremony is officially over, and our bride and groom have taken the floor. Now listen, folks, let's not kid ourselves. These guys have danced together many, many, many times. However, this is the very first time that these guys have danced together as Mr. and Mrs. Seth Durham.
Want you, girl, I mean it. When I say I love you, you're gonna feel it. Each and every day I go out of my way, above and beyond. Just so you don't have to wonder, you're the one I want. Tell you, but I'd rather sing it. And tell your name in the chorus of a love song story. So can't you make everybody wanna sing along?
so you don't have to wonder. You're the one I want. Don't have all the answers when I take the floor. And when it comes to uncertainty, I've never been more sure. Darling, when it comes to you, I never had. The face of the woman in my dreams I've been dreaming about. But your love has grown, and I'll kiss you on the forehead and say, hey baby, what's wrong? You'll say nothing, I just love you, 'cause you never made me wonder. You're the one I want.
Choice to sit it out. never one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Folks, we're about to open this up right here. Are both 53. Is that correct?
No, 52 here, 53 there.
But you know what? Then we'll call it 52 and a half. All right, so listen. Okay, folks. So I need advice. And not me personally, but those two lovely people that were here. What do we got? Guys, you got 53? What's your advice for 50, how to make it 53 years being married?
If mom ain't happy, nobody happy.
Hey, you know what? Brother speaking truth to power right there. That's all there is right there. What about you, sweetie?
You know what? Just stay right beside them and do whatever they're doing.
That's lovely. Yeah. There you go. Good. That's great words. Great, great words. Thank you, guys. No, this is awesome. It's not uh-oh. It's all right. All right. So what do you think? What is your advice to go 52 years? Excuse me.
52 and a half. Excuse me. I misspoke right there. Excuse me. But I stand corrected.
Patience.
With him or just in general? With him or just in general? With him. Patience with him. And what's yours?
Crazy.
Be crazy?
Just be crazy.
Just be crazy. Big Phyllis says just be crazy. No wonder why she has patience, because he just wants to go crazy. I got you, sister. I got you right there. Thank you.
it to them. Here we go. One, two, three. Right at her. Didn't spill a drop. Did not spill a drop. Not a drop. Pictures. Good catch, baby. Good catch. You got good hands. Oh, that's a quick man right there.
It was not boring. No, it was not. Don't tell him that. No, it was not. It was great. It was awesome. Great job, Seth.
Hey, great job.
You do not, sweetheart. You got to clear out because these guys are going to... All right, gentlemen, I want to see a rumble. I want to see some action, boys. Come on. Get up here, boys. Get them all up here, Seth. Get them all up here. Okay. Good job, Seth. Good job, you guys.
I want a Sunday kind of love, a love to last past Saturday night, and I'd like to know it's more than love at first sight. And I want a Sunday kind of love. Oh, yeah, yeah. I want a love that's on the square. Can't seem to find somebody, someone to care. And I'm on a lonely road that leads to nowhere. I need a Sunday kind of love. I do my Sunday dreaming. Oh yeah, and all my Sunday scheming. Every minute, every hour, every day. Oh, I'm hoping to discover a certain kind of lover. Someone to enfold.